Hello everyone. So after the basic principles, that is fundamental principles and scientific management, now let's move forward to our next topic, that is delegation of authority. Delegation of authority is a process that enables a person to assign a task to others. As a manager or as a leader, you are expected to perform several tasks and meet multiple deadlines to ensure that you achieve your objectives on time. You delegate responsibility to your team members, and also you may create accountability of the person to whom work or responsibility has been handed over. There is one definition according to F.G. Murray. Delegation of authority means assigning work to others and giving them authority to do it. Now, next is elements of delegation of authority. Of course, in definition, we had talked about authority, responsibility, and accountability, right? So, elements of delegation of authorities are again, authority, responsibility, and accountability. If you are giving any responsibility to a person or to his or her employee, then it is necessary to give them authority to take decision as well. Only then the accountability of subordinate can be defined. So here, responsibility is the obligation of a subordinate to properly perform the assigned duty. But it is necessary if we want that subordinates do his work properly, then it is necessary to give him the authority to take decision. Decision can be related to the use of resources and to do or not to do something. Next is accountability. It means answerability of subordinate. If he has not done his work properly, then he must be answerable to his superior for his bad or good work performance. Now, next is decentralization, which is opposite to centralization. Centralization refers to the process in which activities involving planning and decision-making powers are retained in the hands of head officer or top management, and other officers receive commands from the main officer. So this is centralization. There may be some advantages of centralization or there may be some disadvantages of centralization. If I talk about advantages of centralization, then we can say that a clear chain of command will be there. When an organization follows a centralized management structure, it can focus on fulfillment of its vision and ease. It may reduce cost. It may be result in quick implementation of decision and it may improve quality of work. But when we talked about disadvantages of centralization, then first disadvantage came, that is bureaucratic leadership. And just to overcome these disadvantages of centralization, decentralization came into existence. Decentralization is the process by which the activities of an organization, particularly those regarding planning and decision making, are distributed or delegated to subordinates as well. That is, away from a central or authoritative location or group. It means superiors will not only take the decision, but they will take the suggestions from their subordinates as well. So, decentralization is a situation which may result in systematic delegation of authority throughout the organization. So, this was all about centralization and decentralization. Thank you.